switch this to here.
The open space and peek inside.
Good. square store itself. There's the side room that you are walking in on. It has a cot and some shelves. Yeah, there's the remains of a human scattered amongst the floor.
I would like to. Davos says, "Oh, that's amazing," and runs inside and hides.
Okay. Give me a. Oh, you have. That's right, you have basically true sight. You have super duper night vision goggles from awesomeness with Microsoft Inside Power.
And I'm having a lot of fun with it.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, okay. You run inside. Yeah, there's still some things scattered around. And you can go ahead. Do you want to stealth or just hide?
I just want to hide.
Okay.
I'll follow him in.
Alright.
Do we have a small view of this room?
That's a good question.
It doesn't look like it.
No, we do not.
Okay.
It means it's all theater of the mind, gentlemen and gentlemen.
Alright. Nice trot in there with the torch and see, light the room up.
Okay, again, still see a lot of stuff. There's broken bottles and lamps, and shelves look like they've been pulled off the walls. Davos is nowhere to be seen.
So there's nothing.
Any of you.
So is it just the one room, or is there more than one room?
You're in a room, and then there's a door that opens up to the main part of the store that has been pulled off of its hinges.
I'm going to start trying to find the awesome thing that Davos mentioned.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to go and look around this room.
Give me a perception.
A natural 20.
10.
That makes that hard. Let's see. Can I see a character sheet really quick? Let's pass the whole book. It's fine. You roll a natural 20, I want to give you something that you don't have to figure out who it goes to.
Like a rubber chicken. Don't know who gets that.
Like a chicken of rubber.
Speaking of which, why do you have a rubber chicken?
Trying to stand up.
You said you rolled a 10, Jonathan?
Yes,
sir. I was
giving
it today as a gag because of his hand.
Alright, anybody else searching for anything?
No, but Davos starts quietly going, "Help me."
You guys hear a disembodied voice saying, "Help me."
Can I see Davos with the giant torch in my hand?
I doubt it. What's your passive perception?
My passive perception? Where's that? Passive wisdom perception, 11.
Nope.
Okay. So, I'm going to continue to look around, see if I see anything.
Give me a perception check. Are you looting, or are you just looking?
I'm looking for loot.
So you're looting?
Yes.
Okay. Perception.
I keep forgetting what I had.
Can't help but
18.
Think of looting and, like, grabbing teeth.
So,
I know.
You come across.
It's kind of like an image association.
You come across this bag.
We call it flat
screen. It seems different than the rest. It's buried underneath some broken shelves and some dust. And you're doing the classic thing of picking it up and trying to shake it out. When you shake it out, nothing comes out, not even dust. So you're going to stick your hand in it. Give me a dex save.
Dex save? Uh oh. Like a 20.
You have a d20 plus your dex save modifier.
Anything special? I doubt. Oh, it says I have advantage on dex saving throws against effects I can't see, such as traps and spells. Ah!
This is neither a trap nor a spell.
Oh, darn it.
Oh, is it a spell? I'll give you advantage anyway.
Alright, so that one was an 18.
for someone to walk by so I can jump out and go boo.
Okay.
Just
at this point,
readying that reaction.
At this point, you may pick any of the three. Eloise is just kind of sitting there and she's rummaging in the well. She finds something.
Who's closest to me?
You can roll a d6 and divide, and 1 and 2 are, it just goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
It's a 3.
So, John.
John.
Yeah.
I jump out and go, boom!
Oh! Davos, is that you?
And then
hello?
I attempt to duck behind again.
Did I see this happen?
You did.
And this doesn't require attunement, right?
No, it does not.
I'm going to expend one charge of my Mace of Terror and select Davos.
It's a fire race, so we can do
whatever you need to. What does Mace of Terror do?
Each creature of my choice within a 30-foot radius must succeed on a wisdom saving throw or become frightened of me for 1 minute.
This isn't good. Natural 20.
Oh.
I have a minus 1 in wisdom too, so that was not looking good.
Oh, nice.
So, does anybody see me?
Yes, now everybody sees me.
Alright. So I would like to stand up.
Okay.
And say, haha, I gotcha. And look around again to see if I see anything.
Go for it.
With my new perspective. Attack. What'd you guys get? Find anything good?
I found a Mace of Terror.
I found an empty bag.
What can you do with a Mace of Terror? That sounds wonderful.
It's actually, see, this is a special trading post. It's a special mace.
I keep collecting these, which is good because I need them.
Yes.
Alright.
Is there anything else of value in here?
No.
Alright, so we can consider this room cleared.
Yeah.
You consider the whole building cleared.
Let's roll out.
Let's go to
the
next
one.
Can
I check
one
to see if there's life signs on the skeleton?
Yes, give me a medicine check against the disembodied, dismembered figurine of a human.
6.
As far as you can tell, it's probably not undead.
All right, guys, I think it's dead.
All right.
Let's leave.
Yeah, let's
go to this other building to our left here.
I can't trust your environment.
Never know.
Which right building are you going to?
The next farm.
We're going out the front door. I guess there's a little building right there.
All
right,
no, go back up,
okay.
Because as you come to the door, due to the boom and the scare, there are two goblins. Everybody roll initiative.
Damn. Natural 1.
Same.
So you want to duke it out over who gets... Last
I will let
place
you go before. Oh my, you guys might be in for a treat tonight.
I think I've mentioned it before, I roll a lot of ones.
Oh no!
Do you know what just happened to me?
Hmm.
Two ones?
One and a two.
Ooh.
And now I roll for Halloween. And a one. Oh, okay, so 20 to 25.
And you always roll high. There is something weird going on.
Well, I've got advantage on initiative. I rolled a 2 and a 17.
All right, so that's 19. So 15 to 20.
18.
17.
Oh, dear Lord. What happened?
What always happens? It's not surprising to me. It's surprising if I roll above a 10.
So then it goes down to I have somebody, and then I'm going to let you and Heloise fight out who goes second and third to last,
mm-hmm,
versus I. And then I'll
that's fine. Situational awareness.
So we'll do Heloise.
So I just kind of clumped everyone together there. Is that where we're standing?
Yep.
Okay. Since I'm right up there and I'm holding this mace, I'm going to swing the mace.
All right. At which one? The one to the north or south?
Probably the one to the north.
Are we still inside the building? Or in?
You are jammed up at the door.
I'm assuming it's going to have the stats in my other mace plus one.
Yes.
Okay.
You're almost dead.
You're
that
right.
Is
I forgot about that.
Seven to hit.
Seven to hit. That is a swing and a miss.
All right. Then I'm going to try to not get out of its combat range, but move out. Can I move to here? Is that too far away?
You're fine there, yeah.
Okay.
All right. So that ends Yeltars, which brings us to Apollo.
We're still inside the building, so don't do anything dumb.
Yeah, I'm gonna move up closer.
We'll fire on everyone.
Can we get to within striking distance? Actually, if I can, since y'all tarsed it, I'm gonna move over here. Just around this east. Alright, then I'm gonna do an Eldritch Blast.
Okay, talk me through Eldritch Blast again.
It's a 1d10.
Is it eye roll for a DC?
Yeah. Wait, hold on, let me check, make sure.
Versus spell attack.
Yeah, you have to vote for a DC.
I doubt that I did not beat you.
You sure about that?
Natural 20.
Yeah.
You don't roll. It's against your spell DC. I believe so, yeah.
Is it half?
Your spell should say it.
It says on a hit, target takes 1d10 force damage.
It doesn't say on a fail save? On a hit?
Yeah.
And it says I'm rolling against your spell DC?
No, I think I have to roll if
spell
I'm in
attack.
The hit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, there's a waste of a natural 20.
Good. Not really. Do I roll d20 or... Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, roll d20.
No.
Is that what I think
you
it is?
You didn't waste your natural 20.
You got a 1.
So it wasn't a waste of a natural 20.
Oh, no.
All right. So what I'd like for you to do is to 1, 2. What's the range on the Eldritch Blast?
120
feet. 120
feet?
Oh, no.
God.
I'm not going to be participating in this battle, guys.
Six. I want you to roll a d6.
Oh,
you just torched the entire village.
That's not D6.
Is it?
D6 is your dice.
Oh.
Yeah, it's the one that looks like a normal dice that you would roll.
5.
1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I want you to go ahead and roll your D10.
Oh, sorry.
second pull move puts me right here. Done. That's as far as I can go with 60.
Okay. So you, Andre rushes back around the building after being blown back against the fence like a WWF wrestling move from the 80s by a very powerful blast from his teammate. All right. Now
he's
going
to use a bonus action to yell a cuss word at the gentleman that did it.
From the top group, we drop all the way down to the bottom group. The goblin that Yltharis tried to hit and Apollo tried to hit is now going to laugh at Apollo and then take a swing at Yltharis.
Look out, Yltharis!
With a scimitar. Probably not going to hit. That would be a 9, 10, 11, 12. Alright, so seeing that he misses, he is going to use Nimble Escape and move 5, 10, 15, no, we're going to go 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, move here, and he's going to...
Does that prevent us from taking a reaction?
Yep. He can use disengage as a bonus action at the end of each of his turns. Now we are to Heloise and Davos.
I, Davos, do solemnly swear to down one of these healing potions.
Good. That's a bonus action.
Woo!
4.
It's an action to give.
6. 7, 8, 9, 10. I have 10. I now have 12 hit points, because I was at 2.
Nice.
I would have not made it through that encounter. and I have a guy to my...
That's
within reach.
That's what you used.
Pass it down, please.
You have a guy within your reach, yes.
That I would like to... Is Yeltaris touching him?
He's within 5 feet, yeah.
So I would get sneak attack on him.
Yes, plus he hasn't attacked yet, but that's later. But yeah, you would have sneak attack.
So I will stab him with my rapier.
You're going to stab him?
With my rapier.
With your rapier. So you're going to rapier him?
I'm going to rapier him. And he will like it. If I can find an 8. So I got to roll first. That's not going to do it. 13.
No.
So, no means no?
No means no.
Alright. That's my move.
Alright. And now we are moving on to Heloise. Heloise is going to kind of push past Davos a little bit. Stand right here. And she's going to do something that she hasn't done in a long time. I don't think she's ever done. She's going to reach out and touch the goblin.
Touch.
And she's going to inflict wounds. So she's going to do 3d10 damage.
That's not very paladin-like.
Good.
That's 10.
She's not a paladin, is she?
17.
What is she?
Claire.
Claire.
Yeah.
19, 20, 22, 23 damage.
I didn't know she had that kind of attack.
I don't think she knows she has that attack.
She has that kind of attack.
She usually just heals.
Is the goblin dead now?
Oh, it's toast. Yeah. So she reaches out, she says, "No more!" And she grabs his arm, and you just hear this goblin shriek. And he's just starting to shake, and blood starts pouring out of his nose.
That's a Yeltaris move.
he falls to the ground, twitching, 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 going rigid. And you smell the faint smell of burning flesh. And she says, "Let's get the other one."
That was 3d10?
Andre,
yeah, that's more than I can do right
Andre
now.
Andre just kind of stands there with his mouth open for a second.
You're sitting there with your big axe, and you're like, I can't touch somebody and kill him.
And she's going to move the rest of her move. That was 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and right next to Bill.
Who is now terrified.
Who now gets to go? I didn't pay attention.
say that during your turn.
I didn't.
Do I
right,
actually...
so you don't actually know
no.
that.
And we're here to kill goblins, and I see a goblin.
Yes.
So I'm going to try and kill a goblin. he's further away. I'm going to... Does it cost anything to switch weapons?
No.
Then I'll pull up
a
crossbow.
Like a bonus action.
Yeah, I'll shoot with a crossbow.
Okay.
No, that's a 7 to hit.
7 to hit total?
Yeah.
That is not a hit.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright. Miss.
Then that's all I got. I'm not doing anything else.
Okay. We are to Apollo.
Okay.
Careful.
Let me see. Who am I closest to? I'm going to...
There's only one person on that map right now that you want to hurt.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Andre just got back, so...
Going to the opposite direction.
So I'm going to face Andre.
I'm next to a similar move. Use my crossbow as well. It seems like a safer, less damaging move.
Shoot, no million damage.
I came close with my roll.
You did.
Six.
Okay. Yeah, you still miss, but don't forget those modifiers.
Yeah.
Alright. Then we go to Andre. Welcome back to the fight, Andre.
You're
nice
still
to see
really
you.
Far away.
I don't think I can actually even get there this one time. Let's try it. Let's see.
You're in
5.
You can get there. It's 25.
15,
you're 25 away.
25.
You're 25 away. I just counted it out.
So I can get where? Here?
Yeah.
Alright, so I only got one rage left, so I'm just gonna swing my great axe.
Lob Eloise's head off.
At the goblin. At the goblin. 2.
That's not gonna do it.
That's not.
Two
not good.
Plus 5. That's
seven.
A 7.
There are creatures you hit with a 7. This isn't one of them. All right, so Andre, thank you for joining the fight. And then it is now his turn. Which means I need to do this because I didn't do it last time.
Andre's not feeling so good.
All right, so he already had the crossbow ready. He is going to take an obstructed shot.
Going to react to that with a psychic backlash
okay.
to impose disadvantage on the attack roll.
Okay.
Ooh.
That was the disadvantage roll. Second roll was an 18.
Okay, so it still hits me?
Yes.
By hitting me, you take 2d10 psychic damage.
Beautiful.
But I let's resolve the damage.
Resolve my damage first.
Yeah.
Alright, and it's just 1d6.
That is crazy.
6 plus 2.
So no matter what,
you do more damage by getting hit.
You take 4 damage.
Alright.
And I take, I'll let you roll your 10s. Yeah.
Okay, 2d10. It's 17.
17 damage, you say. Is that all?
Yeah.
Okay, well, yeah. So, you see Bilk. Bilk. B-I-L-K. Kind of like reach around underneath the armpit of Andre and fire his crossbow, and you just see it just fly through the air, and as it hits Yeltaris, you just see him go and just fall back as his eyes bust out of his head from this just unknown wave of what the hell just happened.
trying to not hit you.
Yes. It's better for me, too.
With that, you are out of initiative.
By the way, I forgot to tell you, I have this spell that when I roll a 1, I get 3 times damage on whoever I'm shooting at.
Oh, that's good to know.
It's a special ability. It's from my homebrew. I made it. It's called the Croak.
The Croak.
Nice.
So what do you guys like to do?
I would like to search his body real quick.
Okay.
You're way over there.
Yeah, that's why I said real quick.
Because
I wanted to interrogate him, yet I didn't get a chance to tell everybody not to kill him.
Because
we're looking
for
a person.
You want to write this down.
Who sent you?
You find a tinderbox.
Tinderbox.
Smoking pipe. A stuffed teddy bear.
Teddy bear.
A box set of three dragon antique cards.
Three dragon antique cards.
Which are worth about 1 gold piece total. All right. So you search the one that's up by the house by the other group. Heloise just looks down in disgust at the goblin. Andre, are you wanting to search that one?
Why not?
Okay. You want to check for traps? No? Okay, good. So you find a small pouch that contains 4 copper and 3 silver.
4 copper, huh? 3 silver.
To make a point about the fact that I think we should be interrogating these people, I walk deliberately over in front of Heloise, look at the goblin, and start interrogating him.
Give me an intimidation check.
That is a 14.
So very impressively, Davos has got this goblin by like the collar. He's smacking him around a little bit. Take me to your leader. Why are you here? What's your name? Where'd you come from?
I was like, dude, I think he's
and,
gone.
And the goblin is beyond dead. Okay? Like, he has loosed himself of his bodily fluids. There are no eyes. The tongue is like flapping around. It's like this sickening.
You melted his face off.
I mean, it was his fault.
As a matter of fact, roll a d6.
Uh-oh. 6.
He is so loud that it's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. And from to your southwest and up on the hill that you cannot see because that's how it should be, you can see a windmill. About to go tilting windmills. You see
see how far you had to actually use the scroll bars. Okay. Can we measure how far that distance is?
From you?
Yeah.
Oh.
70 feet.
70 feet. Then I will walk forward about
5, 10 feet.
Because I think my crossbow is 60. Let me see. No, it's 80. I'll just stay here and fire a crossbow.
Go for it. Where the, so 80 is still within the okay range?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a 15.
It's a 15? That hits.
Alright, so 1d8. 9 damage, piercing damage.
Okay, noted.
And I'll just stay where I'm at.
Okay.
It's a lot of range.
Oh, did you say 9 damage?
Yes.
Never mind, he falls.
Huh.
So, from the back of the group, Yeltaris just goes. And you just hear. And you see the goblin go fall back, and in the profile of the fire from the inside the door, you see an arrow bolt, a crossbow bolt, sitting right between the eyes, and he falls back to the ground.
Yeltaris, you're scary, dude.
Davos turns around and says, Yeltaris, I couldn't have been any more clear. We needed to do a non-lethal blow on this guy so we can tear him.
Because you were up next anyway. So with that...
I mean, we're here to kill goblins. The goblin came out and fired. I killed it. That's what we're here for.
I'd say great shot, Yeltaris.
Well, obviously we should check out the windmill next. So
well,
apparently we're still on initiative.
You're still in initiative.
Wait, what? I thought the goblin died.
Well, he did cough back.
One of them died.
There's another one apparently hiding somewhere.
One of many. Alright.
Well, we don't know that, so Yotaris pulls out his parchment and starts writing.
Longo, L-O-N-G-O.
I was gonna see if there's loot next to our freshly killed goblin.
You have to get there first.
So are we still taking turns?
Yeah,
You can actually go Davos.
Okay, alright.
I would like to look around to see if I see anything. Apparently
you can tell that there's movement inside the windmill.
Okay. I would like to attempt to hide myself since I'm right by that rock.
Okay.
And I guess I'll roll for that.
So you can stealth?
Yeah. Okay. That is a 21.
Alright.
And I would like to ready a shot with my crossbow.
What are you readying for? Are you just readying a shot?
Readying a shot for the next bad guy I see.
Okay.
worst barbarian ever.
You do need to make a decision.
It's Andre the Friendly Barbarian.
Alright, I'm going to go down by Davos there by the rock, and then just kind of peek out over the rock and see if I can get a perception.
Go ahead and give me a perception check. You still carrying your torch?
Yep.
Perfect.
What are you perceiving?
I'm trying to figure out what's going on.
What was your stealth check?
21.
Okay. Good to know.
16 plus perception 2, so 18.
You can see a lot of motion in the firelight that's coming out the door from where that goblin was standing. And with that,
to that with a psychic backlash?
You may.
I will do so to impose disadvantage on the attack.
Alright, this is.
Alright.
That's good.
Alright, so I believe I hit definitely Andre. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so you take. So three crossbow bolts came from the inside of the windmill at once. And that will finish their surprise. So now I get to go again. Yeltars again. Miss. Now we are to finally Apollo.
Torch a windmill.
Closer.
I'm down with that.
Same distance. 1, 2, 3, 4.
There's nobody living here. They don't even know.
Yeah. Right.
What's your range and your fire?
That's just a spot to check.
I'm moving the dead goblins out of the way so that way they don't get confused. Are you guys, nobody gets confused with that.
30 feet.
It might be. It could be. It's 35 feet to the windmill.
Wait, Devin?
You're also moving uphill.
Range?
You also have a 15-foot climb.
That's what I was checking from my... Because I don't want to get too close to it because of the crossbow action.
You're already in crossbow range.
You're already in crossbow range. They were
hit. I was in crossbow range.
Just to let you know, because of the inclination, you're going to have to get here. And even then, it's going to be a difficulty because you'll be trying to use it going up a 15-foot incline.
Yeah, but how tall is it? He doesn't have to hit the base of it.
He can't see the base from the bottom of it. It's a 15-foot incline and 15 feet.
It's true.
Okay. Well, I'll stand next to Yaltaris at first of 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. I can take him get this far.
And then your attack would be at disadvantage?
Yeah. Oh, that's outside of range. It's 35 feet. He's 35 feet to...
Well, he didn't move his full range.
I didn't move my full range. This is my full range.
Oh, yeah, then you'd be at disadvantage, but you can still do it. actually, can you? No. You have to spend half of your move.
The whole time.
It's 30 feet to the side.
And you have
to spend half of your move.
So that's 15.
To get up. So you have 15. So you have 45 feet total if you do nothing else.
Yeah, that's going to be the end of my turn.
Okay. Okay.
Which means you can't hide.
So give me your stealth check.
Wait, that means I can't hide?
You give me your stealth check.
You wouldn't be able to hide at the top.
Alright, stealth is d20 plus 1. Oh, wait. Ouch.
Perfect. This makes sense. It's a natural one. Which is completely
clank, clank,
makes
clank,
sense.
Clank, 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 I can do this, guys. Don't worry. Aha. Hey, I see you over there, Davos, by the door, about 5 feet away, wearing all black. Way to go, buddy. So that's what's happening.
Goblins, I'm hiding.
I'm hiding. You don't see me. Waving like 7 torches around. Nobody can see me. On top of that, I also need a dex check, please.
Is it still
running up the hill?
Yeah. 11 plus 1.
Just
11?
Yeah.
Alright. Well, you could have used your modifier.
Oh.
So 12.
This wasn't a save. It wasn't
gotcha.
A dex save. It was just a dex. Okay. So that's about 35, 40 feet. You have about another 2 squares you can move.
A little bit more towards the back.
Go there.
One more.
Or there.
Yeah, there.
There, okay. All right. That was a good move there, Andre. Minus the clank, 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 clank.
I just wanted to get out of fire and reach.
All right.
Clank, clank, clank.
Clank, 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 clank.
Apollo.
I'm at a solid 4. So.
Alright, well, that's a solid 12 coming at you.
Okay.
To hit. Get your AC.
That's a miss.
Okay.
Thank
you. Yeltaris. That's a solid 11 coming at you.
That is a miss.
Okay.
So I'm gonna reload myself.
Apollo, you are up.
Well, the first thing I'm going
to
do is...
Might be worth using a bonus action to drink your healing potion.
Yeah, I was going to do that
you're
it's a
over
disadvantage
80.
If it's over 80.
Yeah,
it's and it has a range of 320.
Total range of 320.
Okay.
Yeah.
So a melee range, it's a disadvantage. And over 80, it's a disadvantage.
So 10 feet is melee range.
Well, it depends on the creature.
Depends. For a crossbow, it's about 5 feet. For a longbow, it's like 10 feet. No. Crossbow is 10 feet. Longbow is 5 feet. So anything less than 5 feet would make sense to use a longbow or a shortbow. Crossbow, 10 feet, it makes sense. This is about the average length of one step. It takes less than one step to pull a trigger, but it takes longer than one step to draw an arrow. We can talk about physics if you want, but we're not going to. Alright, so Heloise has gotten to where she can see into the door, and she is ready in her crossbow. This is about to get ugly, I think. And you just see Davos, you can see some movement, and you just hear Heloise say, "Hey!" As she goes to shoot into the door, the crossbow bolt flies wide and hits Davos in the left arm, taking 4 damage. She goes, "Sorry! Sorry! Sorry!"
Guys, we're doing more damage with our...
Sorry!
There's one
in the door.
Alright.
And with that, this is where it gets interesting. I'm going to move this goblin out of the way. Because at that point in time, there's a loud ruckus of children walking on people's lawns.
Get off my lawn. Space.
Not walking through your space. They're walking up to Heloise.
I haven't had a turn yet.
Who's adjacent to you?
Anything.
Yeah. Oh, that's going to be interesting. So the first one is going to get to Heloise, and he's going to swing his scimitar. And he misses. The second one is going to get there. Did you hide? You stepped up.
Yeah, I'm still 24. Right.
And he's going to swing at Heloise. All by herself by the door, essentially.
Good man.
He's gonna hit. He'll do damage in a minute. The third one's gonna walk out.
Hit her.
It's like, it's the best show ever.
With the scimitar.
I'm still trying to figure out what she's gonna do.
Right.
Watching her get beat out. I'm like, what is my plan of attack here?
I think it'll depend on whatever I happen to do.
That's true. You're gonna mind bang all the death.
Right. It's like,
in one
let,
move.
Let your cars get hit.
That's the best move.
Three goblins flood out of the door, and they're all swinging the scimitars at Heloise, and Heloise is like, dabbing? She's dabbing. Heloise is dabbing. Heloise invents the dab. She's like, "No, you can't touch me." And only one of them hits her, and she takes 5 damage. Alright, good to know. And with that, we're back to the top of the order. Because you're getting up there. That has all happened since you got up there. All this calamity happened since you got up there. Because it went Yeltaris, you, and Andre moving up there.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Hey,
so,
Davos, do you want to interrogate him now? There seems
Yeltaris,
to be
you are up.
Minutes.
You
I
see these goblins flooding out.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
I see Davos. You saw Heloise kind of fending them off.
I can get up to them with my normal 30 speed, right?
I believe so, yeah. 5, 10, 15. Yes, you can.
So I'm going to get kind of right up as close to them as I can. Yes. And I'm going to expend another charge on my Mace of Terror.
It's going to hit me.
Probably he can't see you.
Well, it's creatures of my... each creature of my choice. So since I can't see Davos, I'm just going to choose the goblin.
Yeah. doesn't change the fact that there's a one rolled.
No, that's not how
that's
this works.
That's true. It's...
Okay.
You say the goblin's
so
in
they have
the
to...
off my lawn.
They have to make a wisdom saving throw. 15.
I guess 15. Easy enough to fail. For goblins. One pass, two fail.
It's
still not crit most of the time.
Well, he has movement. He can still do, so.
Am I now seeable?
You are seeable.
So I would like to...
So you essentially just saw the shadow move and go, ha-ha! Oh, shit.
I will use my cunning action to disengage.
Okay.
And attempt to rehide.
Okay.
Sees this goblin up here.
What do you see? How do you see them?
Yeah. Don't see the one side of the building.
No, they're really in the doorway. You just saw Eloise fend one off. You know that there's one there. That's all you know.
Alright, so I'm going to walk up to the one that's right around the corner.
Okay.
Here. Yeah, like right there.
I think it's going to be exciting when Apollo sets the place on fire and we're all there.
That'll be after you kill all of them. You walk like, okay, guys, I got this. It's on fire.
Wait, where did we go? Then I start.
It's I hate to do this, but I'm gonna use my last rage.
Okay.
And I'm going to swing at the goblin.
Rage against the goblin.
Oh, I should have taken that bonus action.
Because I'm almost dead, which is why I did that.
And now he has catch a cold.
All right, so now it
he
is...
Now has sniffles.
Spin him down.
He's lucky he'll sneeze himself to death.
Move some dust in his face.
All right, so this one is going to... takes a grievous wound from a scimitar, and you hear her scream in pain as she drops into like a fighter stance with one knee bent and the other one down and her fist in the ground because she's just got the wind knocked out of her from a scimitar blow across her rib cage. As you can see, even in the dark, you can start to hear the pulsing, sucking sound of her lungs working against an open wound.
Does she have a save dice?
Doesn't sound like she's unconscious.
No, she's not unconscious, but she's damn near.
She's,
Apollo, you were up.
Pretty close.
Pretty close.
I don't think anyone else has a saving move to help.
If someone was gentlemanly, they would step in there.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, I don't think we have anyone like that.
Hey, I came up and attacked the goblin.
You raged. You definitely raged. Alright, I'm gonna, close to the action now that I feel a little healthier. I'm gonna
trip on a cat.
Oh,
yeah.
No, he's gonna set me on fire.
I think I'm starting to get a reputation.
There's gonna be a festival named after you. It's gonna be called Burning.
It's gonna be a big dragon.
It's gonna be a giant party. We're all gonna light somebody on fire.
Alright.
Part of the flame bringer.
Brings it to the wrong people every time.
That's like, it's like everybody.
He can't see you, right?
No,
gonna be a 30-foot cone.
I
just happened to be.
Yeah, I'm just over his passive perception.
How stealth are you right now?
I was a 14, I think.
13 or 14.
13 or 14, and now I'm guessing your passive perception is 12. 12.
Yes.
He's totally gonna kill you.
No.
So when you re-roll, when you roll a new character.
It'll be a monk.
Oh God! Just, I have this character.
Yes. Aaron's gonna be resurrected.
Just checking with us all clumped together. Does anyone one of us have something that gets a bonus for flanking?
One person does.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, you just get sneak attack.
I get sneak attack, but I have to hit.
You don't have advantage when there's people nearby.
Yeah.
Not yet.
You just can sneak attack.
Okay.
All right.
Special shoes.
I'm gonna do my Eldritch Blast.
Playing the character.
He is. Do your thing, man.
Yeah, no.
Bring the marshmallows.
12.
No.
Not slightly.
Close. You're getting closer. A lot closer than that one was. But yeah.
There's no bonus on that.
Oh, to hit plus 5, 17.
That hits.
Oh.
Which one are you aiming at, by the way?
The one that's not scared.
You don't know which ones are feared. You're on the other side of the building. So you don't
is that a cone, or is that
it's
just a you hit one thing?
Right?
No, this is Eldritch Blast.
Oh,
so the dragon
this is
breath
the
is the cone
one. So you're probably, this one would be the one that I would think that your character would
yeah.
probably go after.
Yeah.
Okay. So go ahead and roll your damage. Stand up, use her mace, and swing at the one that's directly next to her, right here.
Whenever I hear mace, I think the spray.
Oh.
Like, uses the mace.
She's countering with a natural
that's
20.
True too.
So her mace does 1d6 plus 2. So.
Now I'm going to think about that.
Three,
yeah.
You're welcome.
5, 6, 7. That one is dead.
Do we have anybody with the ingenuity to create such a thing?
Create what?
Mace.
So she falls in with the mace. She just stands up. She walks up. She hits him with the mace back of the head. He falls forward into the ground. And it is. That's the end of her turn. And he is feared. So he is going to. They can't do anything, right? They just have to run. They can't use disengage or anything. You would think they could use disengage.
Theoretically, you can take the fear.
Super.
points of sword for can't have
I don't think.
Alright, I'm going to assume they can't.
Yeah.
Andre, you were going to get an attack of opportunity. Yeltaris, you're going to get an attack of opportunity.
A frightened creature has disadvantage on ability checks and attack rolls while the source of its fear is within line of sight. The creature can't really move closer to the source of its fear.
Okay, so that is a little different than what I thought.
Yeah,
it doesn't have to run. It doesn't have to run.
It can attack
at
disadvantage.
Then he is going to move out here, and he's going to attack Apollo at disadvantage.
Nice.
So that's his turn. Oh, no, then he will disengage. He moved 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. There, not
is he the only one
closer.
Alive?
Yep.
Wait, is there a guard in that tower down there?
No.
That tower has crashed.
We are back to the top, Yeltaris, you were up.
I'm just going to move, 10 feet forward so I can have a clear sight and mind thrust.
Okay.
And that will be a intelligence saving throw.
12.
Against 13, so that failed.
Awesome.
So, let's do damage. 7.
Dead.
So we killed all the guys.
Everybody is out of initiative.
Well, let's go check out the window.
He's killed like all the two things that we faced the entire journey so far.
I think I have about one body.
Alright, all four of these bodies are piled up by the door.
That's because half my stuff doesn't roll to hit.
Probably killed more of you guys. Hit damage wise.
I'm going to go pick up my torch and come back.
You're going to go all the way back and pick up your torch?
Yes.
Okay.
I knew you had more on.
Nope, that's what he said he's going to do.
We're out of initiative, right? So
it still takes time.
I'm going to loot some of these goblets.
That's what I was hoping to hear.
And I'll go look in the window.
Okay.
Check for traps, of course.
Alright.
It's still nighttime. We're going to need that torch.
Go ahead and give me perception. Give me perception. Are you looting them? Okay. Give me perception.
Mine's 20. Not a natural 20.
So not a good place to bunker down for an hour.
Sure. No.
Okay.
It is lit up like daylight.
Is there like straw or anything like that around?
Yeah, a little bit.
I would like to take a bundle of straw and put it on one of the windmills, like the things, and light it on fire so it goes around in circles.
Okay, give me a nature check. No, survival. You take 3 damage as you almost dislocate your shoulder as the windmill continues to turn while you're trying to use the flint and steel to light what you presume is straw, but it is soaking wet because somebody decided to relieve himself on a pile. But eventually, after a few attempts, you do get it started in this little tiny orange flame. It's just slowly growing.
See, Apollo, this is how you make a fire. So that's it in this area. And there's another building to the southeast before the unpassable bridge to the south.
To be fair, no. There's a few things you guys haven't searched. Just to be fair.
Oh, yeah. That's down this
Up
north.
God, I'm almost dead. I don't want to die. And I have no potions.
It's about another 12 hours before you would be able to take a long rest.
How about a short rest?
The little scroll bar on the upper right.
Because
it's better than that.
I'm almost dead. I need some hit points.
You don't have any healing potions whatsoever?
No, I got no healing potions. I've used my only healing ability, and I got 6 hit points left.
Yeltara's hands you.
6. There's been people in this group that have been hovering around 2s and 1s.
Got level
I
edge.
Started this at 20.
I'm living with 5 right now.
Susanna's down to 1.
Do we want to?
Let's find a nice place to take a rest here, guys.
You're welcome to rest wherever you want. I'm going. Searching more places. I got stuff to find. I mean, people to find.
Go check this building on northwest.
Here's what we can do. We can speed up time and speed up effort, knowing what I know. And we will presume that you guys kind of search through the surrounding remaining few buildings. There's a few things that I'm not going to assume that you're going to search because they're too far away from you. And we can pick this up to where you guys are finishing a long rest to wake up at, you know, the late morning the following day.
Okay.
So you guys can actually have a long rest. You can camp in, and you'll build a barricade, ask for a couple checks, and you can build a barricade in the windmill. But we'll presume that you guys will quickly go search things, come back, I'll give you a treasure drop via email, and we can pick this up in 2 weeks after. We'll pick this up next year to where you guys will be in the windmill, hunkered down, barricaded in, resolving a long rest, and whatever that may mean for all of you.
I'm assuming basically the rest of the town is clear? Like we did it?
For the most part. There's a few things you have not cleared yet that I'm not going to just let disappear.
Okay.
Because they are specifically designed to kick your asses.
Oh, there's an ass kick machine in there.
There is. No, like your donkeys. Sorry, your donkeys.
Well, at this point, one goblin does that, so...
Well, is that the consensus? Is that what you guys would like for me to do? Give you a treasure drop via email, pick up with a long rest to where you guys are waking up at like 10 o'clock in the afternoon the following day, from a long rest to where you can use your hit points and things like that? Is that the consensus?
Yeah, that sounds good.